why? Let's put an example.
That's great.
Man, quick observe. Just because I have
to have, for example, as I told you before, you should not do any kind of organic structures, no caves, no nothing, not related to that, or you don't, because we're going to use the tiles. So, ceiling and in the work, a little pyramid. Far, let's say, okay, that was my layout, so it's funny, etc., etc. What is the next thing to do? Okay, I have this, you already have, and you already created this kind of composition. So far, so good. What's next? What are we going to be having? What is the meaning? In the last project, we made a 3D projection, trying to, of course, that from a 3D model, looks okay in the camera view. So we didn't really take care of it. It looks fine, looks weird, nah. Because at the end of the day, we're supposed to be painting on the top. So it was, okay, all right. Nowadays, with this, we still, and we should be continuing using the camera. But now, we need, again, probably some chocolate that we're looking. What should be a real 3D model? And the characteristics of that 3D model, of course, all should pass. Separate. So individual. So we have one wall, that's one polygon. The floor is another polygon. The pedestal is another polygon. Now we should create a prop. And the treasure is another polygon. Another kind of deformation. Why? Because we need a 3D model first, then we're going to be going to Photoshop, and then we're turning here to Maya. But before start modeling just randomly, we need to take that into consideration. Again, our viewport is our main tool. Your layout, in this case, Maya. Should be the reference. And of course, by style, it will change. I know it will change, so don't worry right now of that, because we need a right, or saying a word, a correct 3D model. That could be loosely based in my layout. I mean, yeah, I can make the super wonky walls, but I have that. Why? Because once we cover it, imagine that the textures, with all the information we want to create from Photoshop, the second, the last part, we're going to be doing Maya, is to store both the camera and also the polygons. We're going to be moving around. But because I already have this information, the texture is not a big deal. We should do that. And with that, we need. And we should be creating this. Okay? So far, that's the step we want to create. First step, grab the layout, check. Second, create a 3D model. Third, create a title. Photoshop. Or return to Mac. So far, we already made this. Before I continue, because this has a different thing, any question on what's going to happen? We're going to start with a 3D model. I'm just going to like in the big picture. We're going to have a 3D model, basic layout. We need to paint the information that's going to happen in the 3D model. Then we should return to the 3D model and make it look weird, cartoony. But that's the last part. Okay? Any question? What's going to happen? Sure?
I see.
So we're going to start with the 3D model. It will not be the same as we did with the last thing. Throw polygons there and hope for the best. We're going to use our layout as a reference. But before we even open Maya, we need a floor plan, layout. It has so many names. Let's say like top upper building because we still need to need the planning. What's going to happen? Again, using the tablet's reference, you can make a sketch. But I need that. It has my layout as a reference. Where should I put the camera? Well, a really pretty neighbor is coming. And where should we put the camera? One of the things we're going to be looking to the camera is that. And oh, come on, you came late and you distracted the little guy?
Handsome guy.
Yeah. How you should do the 3D and the planning. Okay, I'm going to make a floor, I need a wall, because that's the only thing I see. Probably not a wall, probably I need something else. A wall, or probably half a cylinder. Where I should put my little thing. Wow. Okay. From the top, how are you going to be planning? Like architecture, actually, but in a more loose way. Well, you can make it so complex that you need it, but you need the information on which elements I need to be modeled. Because again, it's a planning. You should never go direct to 3D or to Maya and like, okay, let's go for the best, let's see if it works, because you will be overworking. And we don't need that. You don't need that. You don't need to overwork. Just take a break, see what's going to happen, and then act accordingly. This situation, if I'm going to create my layout, here, I have that. I have that as a reference, so what should be taken? What should be created? Well, for starters, I see that this is a cylinder because I have a circular roof. That's one thing. Also, there's a floor. No floor, so no big deal. I should not be modeling a floor because I don't see it in the camera. That's the reason I told you, you should never overwork. Like, okay, one cylinder is thinking, because I know for sure it's a pyramid, pedestal, only one thing, and of course, the treasure. Okay. So far, how many things I have? Oh. That in other view it will look really weird, cheesy, and cheap. But once again, this guy, the camera, is our main tool. Why? Because if we know how to use 3D cameras for animation, not for video games, films, different stories, but still we could do that. Then you can save time, you can save money, and of course you can put more effort in the looks, not in the production, but in the looks at least. Because so far I only need 3 polygons to create that layout. Okay? Many props, keep it simple. Don't worry, don't put many props. Keep it simple. But at least I need to see the walls, something extra in your layout. And make the plan. I want to see the plan before moving to mine. Okay? Any question? It's quick, it's simple. Probably you say, it's foolish. Probably will save you a lot of time, effort, and money. Okay? No questions? Then go for it! Because I need that before going to mine.
Before what?
Need what? This, the phone, the phone plan.
Before what?
Before going to Maya.
Oh.
Have 30 minutes to do the phone.